Hi, this is Joe from J. Alexander Roofing, and I am here at 610 West Circle Street, Findlay, Ohio, and I am here today performing a video inspection of the roof. Kind of give you the state of the roof, my opinion on it, an assessment, a professional assessment. All right, so I've already been up here. I've kind of checked things out, looked around. Some good things and some bad things. A, it's a fairly new shingle. I think I was told this thing was put on in 2008, so it is a fairly new shingle. Looks like a 25 to 30 year product. That's a good thing. That's a good part of this roof. The bad part of this roof is I think we're looking at an inferior install. So whoever put this roof on in 2008 didn't do the best job. Because I'm starting to look at areas like this. Major crack in the shingle. Bear with me as I walk around here. Here we're looking at a major patch job. You know, I know we get high winds, but we're not in the middle of the field out here. Had these shingles been properly nailed, this should not have been an issue. You know, unless you're sitting in the middle of the field, should have no blow-offs back here. And then the patch job is pretty suspect. Leaving you with cracks, breaking, and there's just tons of foot traffic, you know. Terrible patch job, things of that nature. And this whole area right here around the chimney, I don't know if the chimney was leaking at some point or what's going on, so they had to come up here and address it. But just high foot traffic, you know, really wearing down on the shingles. And then another thing I'll talk to you about is these. Zoom in right here. See this nail sticking out? Widespread across the roof. If I wanted to find and circle with chalk, probably 75 to 100 low nails and or nails that are popping up through your shingle. I could easily do that. There's nails popping up through your roof everywhere. Here's a nail underneath here sticking out. And then get down on the phone. Anywhere you walk around your roof and look up and see that bump, that's because there's nails coming up through. I can guarantee you that. There's nails popping up through these shingles right here, large nail. So this nail right here is pushing this shingle up, and that's kind of what's going on widespread throughout this roof. Another thing, and not to nitpick someone else's work, because, you know, there's more than one way to skin a cat, but this is not right. This slope should have been ran first, so all the water sheds off this main slope of the roof, comes down onto that dormer, and runs off your roof into your gutters. So they kind of flipped that around backwards, and some of the things were just done sloppy, which concerns me more and more with the craftsmanship. As you can see right here, crooked row. They didn't take time to snap the lines. We always snap lines. You know, it makes everything look better, clean, and just shows that you're taking your time and care. Then I zoom in onto this valley. As you can see, they almost cut through the, you know, through the primary shingle. So the shingle underneath here is what's going to shed out all the water, keep the ice out, and they got a good gouge right through it. So once again, there's a telltale signs that the craftsmanship on this roof is not that bad. And then what I want to show you, there's a lot of pitting, and you had mentioned maybe there's some hail damage. That's not really hail damage. What's going on is A, when they tore this roof off, they probably stripped it down in the decking, or maybe not, maybe they didn't take the felt paper off. But what you need to do when you're working with an older house like this with one bys and not plywood, you got to secure all that decking. When we come in, we do a full tear off, then a flashing decking and fastener inspection. That fastener inspection would have told us, hey, these boards are kind of loose, because I can feel it when I'm walking around. They're creaking and cracking, things of that nature. So what's happening is just, you know, freezing and thawing over the winter, another low nail, and really anything, just shifting in the house, old house, you know, these houses move, they adjust. So the boards are working up and down a lot, and the shingle is starting to break and crack through, and then the nails are actually popping up through the shingle. Another nail right here. So between that and then just poor install, there's some low nails. You know, you're gonna start being faced with some problems. I can't come in here and you know, morally tell you this roof needs to be replaced because there's a lot of life left into it. But there are some issues that are gonna eventually lead to major issues. And then there's things like this, you know. Right here, I can see felt paper right through there. That's just sloppy, that's just, you know, not caring that much and doing the job kind of halfway, not finishing it. Here's a really good illustration though. This nail is 100% revealed now, and that's what I'm talking about. The decking underneath this is not properly secured, so everything gets wiggled around, and the nails work themselves back up. You don't have to know much about roofing to know that rusted nails poking up through your shingles are gonna be a problem. So, those are some of the main issues we're facing here. You know, once again, here's just sloppy cuts. They cut right through the shingle. So this is not a weather issue, it's not a hail issue, it's not a... I'm not crazy about the product. It's not one of the big three. It's kind of a generic dimensional shingle, but it still should last. You know, if it's installed right, it's going to last. It's not going to completely fall apart, and it's not. The slopes that haven't been touched and the slopes that, you know, don't have nails popping up through them, which is few and far between, they're still in decent enough shape. There's still a lot of granulars on the shingle. They're not curling. They're not breaking. It's just bad install, improper practices are leaving you with a roof that's going to, this roof will fail before, you know its lifespan. It's not gonna, there's no way it's gonna last 25 to 30 years. It's just not, there's gonna be too many problems happening, too many nails poking up through. Eventually it's gonna look like crap. There's gonna be rust streaks all over the roof from the nails, and it will start leaking. So once again, Joe from J. Alexander Roofing performing a video inspection, 610 West Circle Street, Findlay, Ohio. Thank you.